Okay, this will be the last video I'm going to make about the Voynich manuscript, and I just need to say a few things. If you follow my blog, then you know that I took a route trying to describe it in terms of like an Albanian language or something from Greece, some ancient language, and if you watched all that, you know that I eventually ran into trouble with the letters that look like C's, so I couldn't explain those, and I could never come up with anything for those. So I don't quite think it's that. And as far as Italian goes, I've seen other vlogs and people trying to describe it in Italian, and it doesn't really work because the way they translate it, the grammar is terrible, and one sentence goes into another. You have one topic, and then suddenly in the next sentence, it changes completely, so that you don't have a coherent story being told. So, I never really believed that the Voynich manuscript was in Italian. I mean, just because you find the manuscript in Italy doesn't make the language Italian. It could be anything. You know, and there were, like I pointed out in my other videos, there were plenty of other types of people in Italy at the time. So, for a while I believed it was Latin, and most manuscripts written during that time were in vernacular Latin or Vulgate Latin. Actually 70%. I found a pie chart that explained that. So I really, really thought Latin was a good language to try to piece that, connect that with. And it works for just a little while. What I mean is, even if you analyze, if you write out a list of the two and three letter words from the Voynich manuscript, you analyze it, you get a feeling that the letters that look like an A and an O aren't actually vowels. They behave as consonants in the really short words. Okay? It works for a little while. When you try to move on to four and five letter words and you try to figure out what those are, suddenly those letters don't behave like consonants anymore. It changes, okay? So there's no coherency to what you think are vowels and consonants. It gets changed up all the time. So, I mean, I really try to match Latin words with it, so it just doesn't work. And you find them in places that don't make sense. So, what this boils down to, and I know a lot of you aren't going to like this, but I think there's two possibilities going on. The first is that the Voynich manuscript doesn't mean anything. It's completely made up, and so the purpose for that would be obviously money. I think this book was created specifically to sell to King Rudolf II for 600 ducats, and that's all there was to it. Okay, and then the second possibility I could think of is that it does have coherency. It's a language, but it's a completely made up language. Okay, and what I mean by that is someone who is very visual created the words and just wrote it out, and then whatever he created for that word, he memorized it. He committed it to memory. And so that means you could make some guesses about what each word means, but it also means that you'd be guessing and you can never prove it. So even if you have an idea of what one page is saying, there's absolutely no way to prove it. Okay, and I know a lot of you aren't going to like it. That's the conclusion I came up with. But then if you've been watching my blog, you know perfectly well that I did make some good attempts there to try to figure it out. And I can't say that my time was wasted, because I mean, hey, I think I proved to you, to most of you guys, those last two points I was trying to make, and it's been a fun journey. Okay, so That was it. Bye.